Hey lovebugs, it's Roslynn back at you one more again. I hope everybody is doing blessed. I'm doing blessed and highly favored and definitely hope the same for you. And if this is your first time stopping by my channel, much love to you and welcome. And to my returning subs, my grown extended beautiful family, just thank you so much for spreading the love that you have. Even though you might be going through a lot, you know, you're putting those things aside to go ahead and send other people blessings towards their way. So with that being said, much love to all. Namaste, love and blessings, love and light, and many blessings are definitely coming your way. And if you have been watching my videos for a while and have not already, please like and subscribe, even hit that notification bell so you know when I'm about to upload my next video. Also, if you are comfortable enough, please drop me a line or two. I love a chance to get to know you as much as you're getting to know me, even if it's about the positive feedback of the content of my video, or you're just up telling me about your empathic gift and how it impacted your life and heading you towards a positive direction. Also, if you feel like the videos gave you good vibes or good information that you know a fellow empath needs to hear, or you know somebody who's really going through a dark time right now and needs some encouragement, please go ahead and share. And while you're at it, give me a thumbs up, like, and also share on your social media favorites wherever you see fit. And thank you once again for stopping by the channel and showing me so much love. It's greatly appreciated. And I hope you're able to resonate with the content of my video today. And today, my meditation music is, sorry y'all, I had to turn my notifications down, 3 hours of peaceful meditation music, spiritual journey, healing music, relaxing mind, body, and soul, calming sleep, and I will post that link in the description box below. And today my video is about Twin Flame 101, Heyoka's Each Painful Story Has a Successful Ending. Which it is, you know, sometimes when we're going through stuff, it's hard for us to see the positive things that are coming towards our life because we're so fixated on the things that we're currently going through that, you know, we wish that can go away. But you also have to think about it. You have to be patient for the things that we go through. I know it's hard. I'm a Taurus, so I don't have patience like that. But you know what? With this journey I've been on, I had to practice that, you know, because things are not going to happen at our time, you know, when we want them to go. It's all at divine timing. And there are some times that we might be experiencing things and we get frustrated with ourselves and thinking, oh my gosh, I want to hurry up and get over this. Oh my gosh, I want to hurry up and let this go. But you have to be able to do the part of, you know, it won't stay in your conscious mind if you get, you know, put things in order or, you know, start doing more things and just sitting around thinking about the issues you're going through instead of, you know, coming up with a solution for you to be able to do things. Because sometimes we fixate on that problem so much instead of just saying, okay, this is a problem, let me try to fix it, or let me just go on about my business and allow it to fix itself, because, you know, you're putting your mind on towards other things. Because sometimes darkness can come into our life just to be able to shake stuff up, especially when we're heading towards big and beautiful things. You know, we have those things coming on in our life that we want badly and we're working hard for it, and it just seems like we're not getting nowhere. But don't give up on whatever you're going through. Knowing you have a story to tell, you know, you're going through this situation for a reason, for it to be able to strengthen you, for you to get wisdom out of this, you know, be able to help others, because there are so many people struggling nowadays. And it's just like, it's like everybody's feeling everybody. It's like people are waking up, spiritually waking up left and right. A lot of us don't understand why we're going through certain situations, because that is a spiritual awakening. And I know a lot of my subscribers, I love y'all. Y'all be like, Roslynn, we're going through another, you know, going through another spiritual awakening. How many spiritual awakenings I have to go through? And thank you, Reiku, for telling me about the Mercury retrograde. I forgot all about that. So it's just a lot of us are going through all these things. So it's conjuring up a lot of stuff, you know, having us up in our feelings and going through, it feels like we're going through hell in a rotating hamster wheel, you know, and it's going to have its final ending. It's going to have that cut off, but we have to be able to go through it and stay strong and have, you know, stay prayed up. Whoever you pray to, just stay prayed up and ask them for patience and strength going through these situations. You know, we can't have it wished away, because these are things that we all have to experience for us to be able to get where we need to be on that certain level. Being able to know that, you know, you're going through that chapter of life by the situations you experience in life. And when you're able to heal from them and recognize, hey, this was a blessing in disguise to me. Because it's just like when you're so into that moment right there of what is going on and trying to understand, why did this happen to me? Why did this person get taken away out of my life? And, you know, why am I experiencing these certain things in life? And, you know, I always ask God why. You know, why did I, you know, I always knew I had attachments to my father, but why did I find out the truth after he passed away? That was the most hurtful feeling I could ever go through. But knowing I was able to break down those barriers, break down that wall of insecurity, be able to make videos. First, I was doing video diaries to myself, just be able to tell, you know, let it out, because I didn't really trust anybody with these situations that was going on with me. I didn't know I was, you know, I'm thinking I'm losing my daggone mind. But then being able to get out that, out my feelings and know, you know, it's a day-by-day basis. Trust me, I know. You know, you're trying to understand, why do I constantly got to keep going through this? I ask myself that all the time. I say, I push out so much positivity. I pray for other people. I've helped, you know, other people heal. Why can't I just get what I want? And it's like, you can't do that, especially if you still have mixed feelings about other things that you experienced in life. You're not able to let that go. You keep on having that thought in your mind, you know. And it's just like, I tell people my story, and I just tell them, you know, I went through this and this and this and that, but I've helped so many people get through things to let them know this too shall pass. It is what it is. You have to go through certain things like that. Things are a circle of life that we all got to experience. But this was my story. You know, this is my book of life that I done put out to the world to let people know, hey, I went through this. But it takes a lot of courage to be able to open up and tell things like this. And you're not, you know, you worry, especially when it comes to a celebrity. You're always, you know, you could be worried about, oh, are they going to believe you, or, you know, how they're going to perceive you. I had to let all that stuff go, because I said, either you believe me, you don't, you don't. I don't have time to be trying to convince nobody or explain things, because they're only going to see their level of perception to it. So it's just like, knowing you have that story to tell, knowing you're that author to that chapter of your life, all the chapters of your life, but you have to know that you're going through these things for a certain reason. You are facing things, your deepest, darkest fears you are facing right now. And it's like, it's just coming at you and coming at you and coming at you. But it's all these things that you have been holding on to for so long that you'll be able to let go of. And when you finally be able to see everything the way it is, even if it could be the most painfulest things you have ever experienced in life, when you can forgive yourself, forgive your past, and just let it go, and knowing, okay, this past done taught me a lot of things. It wasn't meant to punish you and make you put walls up. That's not what it was supposed to do. It's supposed to show you the things that you need to be taught through this, and learn and heal from them, and keep it moving. You know, it's just like, life is not about you being stuck in a negative place and you just keep reliving that part over and over in your life. I had to tell myself that, because there was a lot of times I thought about, you know, the things I experienced as a child, you know, wanting to be just like my dad and being punished for it, you know, looking just like my father and being punished for it. You know, things that stuff I can't change. You know, that's in my genetics. That's just in the genes. You know, I can't, you know, that's something I can't change. But there are so many times, I'm not going to even lie to y'all, there's times I just want to take a knife and start cutting my face, because it was too painful to know that I was being punished for something I had no choice in the matter of. Even though my dad's a very beautiful person, but I got punished just for those things. But then when I started looking at it, it's like, you know, this served a purpose. You know, a lot of things you might not understand. I mean, even my dad was saying that in the song, Be My Mirror. There's things we're stuck on and we cannot understand, but I'm 100 paces down the road. So it's just like, certain things that I went through, I don't know the full answers to yet, but it has brought me so much positivity. It had me going through milestones, stepping on stepstones that I wasn't even thinking I would be able to deal with. You know, it's just like, time is coming up for my dad's anniversary to pop back up. I don't know how I'm going to react to that, but I said, you know, I just had to tell God, please give me that strength. I don't know what falls in line on that anniversary, but you knew it was hard for me to deal with last year. You know, and it's like I tell people, it's hard to deal with stuff like this. It's like, it's always hard to lose a loved one. But when you are related to somebody who is famous, like, my father's always around, you know what I'm saying? So it's just like, when people start asking me, hey, you want to come do this watch party with us, the whole group of, you know, whatever Prince group that they got out, is doing a watch party, and a lot of them don't know that that's my father. And I said, you know, not to be mean or anything, but, you know, I can't watch a lot of things like that. It's just too painful. So I just hope you understand. And I was like, please don't ask me to get into no, you know, reason why. And they're like, oh, okay, it's understood, you know, because I don't want them feeling like I'm too good to do that or whatever. But it's just like, it's different when you're just not a fan, but you love his music and you love what he stands for to the person that's actually, that's their father. And, you know, and that's just a lot of things I'm not trying to open a wound for that I'm already trying to heal. So there's days I have to listen to his music on my time or look at his pictures on my time. I don't want to be forced to have to do that with a lot of people because all that energy, all that different energy people have is just too much for me. So it is just like knowing that my experience has helped a lot of people and knowing it has put a lot of perspective towards the other things that people have endured. You know, being blessed to be able to know, hey, I'm an indigo. Hey, I'm a Heyoka. I'm a white witch. You know, I'm a medium. All these different things that I've been able to know about myself is truly a blessing. And knowing I can be able to help other people, knowing I'll open myself up to the universe, because I fought against it for so long that I had to go through so much tremendous hell for me to actually recognize what I'm here for. So, you know, knowing, yes, I had a painful story, but towards all this stuff that I'm meeting beautiful people, allowing them to know, you know, you are special in every way you are. You're a gift to God's creation. Now, I try not to cry because there's a lot of times we feel like we're by ourselves. We feel like, you know, people shun us away because we're different. And it's just a beautiful thing to know that you play an important part to this war that we're going through between good and evil. You do matter. You are important. You are not supposed to be shunned, but people fear what they don't understand. They push us away because they don't know why we are the way we are. But it's a blessing to be able to go through these things, even though you might not be able to see it yet, but it's a beautiful blessing for you to be able to endure. Yes, we all have a past. We have all did things that we are not proud of, but what we were able to, what positive outcome we were able to get from that negative impact, that's the thing that matters. You know, don't allow people to keep throwing your past in your face, especially when you're not your past anymore. Don't allow them to do that. Those are the people you need to separate from. Anybody who has to constantly keep reminding you of the things that you have done, knowing that's not a part of you, but it helped you become the person you are. You know, just separate that, because it's just like, you are important. You matter. You're playing an important part. Don't ever feel like you're alone, because you're not. You know, there's things that you don't understand that has not came into play yet. But trust and believe, when you do your part, you be positive. You know, even though through the dark times you see love, know that it has to happen for a reason. You have to go through these things to be able to have that positive outcome. That process you have to go through is going to bring you so much love and joy. Know that it had to happen for a reason. You had to be broken for you to be put back together in the original person you were supposed to be. So know that you are blessed. You have angels all around you. I send y'all support and validation all the time. I told y'all I hate crying, but I feel that. And I know what it feels like to feel like you're alone, that, you know, the world is against you. It's just you against the world. I understand that. So knowing this is a process that you all have to go through, knowing your painful story will have a successful ending if you just take the time and realize you're special just the way you are. So, y'all, before I get any mushier, I'll see y'all in my next video. Peace. Be wild.